stamp your feet, jump up and down, the ground seems pretty solid, right? But this is not always the case. Sometimes the earth can move right under our feet and massive amounts of rock and soil suddenly slide down a hill. What's happening here? Today, we'll uncover the mysteries of landslides, exploring what they are and how they happen. From the high peaks of mountains to the grounds of our own cities, landslides can impact landscapes and human lives. We'll also learn how to spot the signs of a potential landslide and what we can do to stay safe. Grab your explorer's hat and let's go see the science of shifting earth. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. A landslide is when large amounts of rock, earth, or debris moves down a hill or mountain. This can happen suddenly, with little warning, or slowly over time. There are several different types of landslides, each depending on how the material moves down the mountain. Slides are when a big piece of earth moves down all together. Imagine a whole layer of earth sliding off, like a giant cake sliding off a platter. Flows are more fluid and happen when the earth mixes up and moves down like thick, wet batter pouring out of a bowl. Falls happen when pieces of rock or earth fall through the air, usually from a cliff or steep place. And lastly, topples are when big chunks of earth lean forward and then fall over. Each type of landslide has different causes and effects. The reasons for landslides fall into two major camps: nature and people. Rain is one of the most common natural causes. When a lot of rain falls, it can make the ground very wet and heavy, which causes mud to slide down slopes more easily. Earthquakes can also trigger landslides by shaking the ground so much that the earth and rocks can't stay in place. Volcanic eruptions can lead to landslides too, especially when the eruption makes the ground weak or breaks it apart. Some of these natural phenomena can be scary, but we also think they're pretty phenomenal. Get it? That is, they're amazing. Don't miss our whole series about these natural wonders. But now let's talk about how people can cause landslides as well. Huh, embarrassing. When trees are cut down in an area, there are no strong, healthy roots left to hold the soil, making it more likely to slide away. Mining and construction can also make the ground unstable. When we dig into a hill or pile up a lot of heavy material, it can be too much for the earth to hold, leading to a landslide. None of those things would have happened on their own. It's a sequence of events started by people. There is an underlying explanation for all of these landslides that we haven't talked about yet. Have you noticed the constant force that pulls everything toward the ground? Like how when we jump, we always come back down? This force is called gravity. Gravity is what pulls everything down towards the earth, including rocks and mud in a landslide. Regardless of if the ground got too wet from rain, was shaken by an earthquake, or was made unstable by human activities, it's gravity that finally pulls the landslide to move downward. So really, we can blame gravity for everything. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Because landslides are a natural phenomenon, it's not like we can stop the force of gravity. You might wonder why they're worth talking about. Little landslides happen all the time, without changing the course of history. Of course, some landslides are bigger than others, which also means that some are more harmful than others. Some landslides from our history have become well known because of their size and the amount of damage they were able to cause to the people living nearby. For example, in 1963, a massive landslide fell into the 𝙎𝙈𝘼𝙍𝙏𝙺 Dam Reservoir in Italy. This landslide caused a huge tsunami that went over the dam and destroyed several villages. Another famous landslide occurred in 1980 when the eruption of Mount St. Helens, a volcano in Washington State, USA, triggered a massive landslide. This was the largest landslide ever recorded and immensely changed the landscape, flattening forests and raising the riverbeds in the surrounding areas. In 2017, Sierra Leone's capital, Freetown, experienced a devastating landslide triggered by heavy rainfall. It buried much of the city under mud and left many people homeless. When you're on a mountaintop, it looks so peaceful. Who would imagine parts of the mountain could suddenly fall down? While it may be hard to believe, there are actually some signs that can help us tell if a landslide is coming. If you know what to look for, you might be able to tell when a landslide could happen. One big clue is changes in the landscape. If you see new cracks in the soil or pavement, or if small rocks start falling down a hillside, it might mean that a larger landslide is about to occur. Trees that lean to one side, or the appearance of bulging ground at the base of a slope, can also be signs of shifting earth. Even though they're a part of nature, landslides can be dangerous and destructive, so scientists and engineers work together to do everything in their power to prevent them. One effective method is building something called retaining walls. These are strong walls built at the base of a slope to help hold the soil in place. If the soil is kept in place, it removes the risk of it sliding around. Another technique is terracing our mountains. Terracing is done by cutting the slopes of mountains into steps. They look a lot like stairs in a home. We also can't forget drainage systems. These help by directing rainwater away from vulnerable slopes, preventing the soil from getting too wet and heavy, which, now you know, can lead to a landslide. A more colorful and beautiful way to prevent landslides is by planting vegetation. Can you believe that? Planting trees, bushes, fruits, and vegetables can help prevent landslides. This is because their roots help to hold the earth in place and stabilize the soil. There are even some native grasses whose roots go down meters and meters. All of that helps, naturally. That's pretty much the rundown when it comes to landslides. While landslides can be scary, they also show us something important about our world. Everything is connected. The rain, the soil, the sun, our oceans, mountains, and so much more are all part of one bigger system. Landslides are a natural event that get created by some natural wonders and create others. What a world of wonders we live in. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.